In today's webinar, we'll be taking an in-depth look at the new Facebook login that was announced at the F8 conference this past April. We have an awesome guest from Facebook, Peter Yang, who will walk you through the need-to-know Facebook login updates and also provide best practices for getting the most out of your implementation. We also have Marissa Wang, who's Gigya's Director of Product Strategy, and she'll be on hand to help answer any Gigya-specific questions. So before I hand it over to Peter and Marissa, there's just a few logistics to cover before we get started. The presentation will last for about 30 minutes, which will give us plenty of time at the end for Q&A. And at any time, please send in your questions through the GoToWebinar questions window, and we'll address them at the end of the session. Also, this webinar will be recorded, and we'll follow up with a link to the recorded version via email. And with that, I'll hand it over to Peter to kick things off.
Cool. Thanks so much, Kevin. So my name is Peter. I've been working on logging for about a year and a half now at Facebook. I'm really excited to talk to you guys today about the biggest update we made to logging since we introduced the product. So just to begin, the agenda for today's webinar is first we'll talk about the new Facebook login, and then I'll walk you guys through how we can use the new Facebook login. Let me just make sure the slide progresses. There we go. Cool. So let's talk about the new Facebook login first. So before we go into this, let's kind of have a brief history lesson about logging. Back in 2012, our login dialog for mobile looked like this. And as you can see, it presented a lot of information, and including a lot of people to select which audience, for example, they wanted the app to post to. But people gave us feedback that it was still too complicated. So in 2013, we decided to split read and write permissions. So read permissions is people sharing information with the app, and write permissions is the app asking for permissions to post back to Facebook. And just splitting these two permissions, this small change, led to a 10% increase in Facebook login conversion rates. So when we started thinking about the new Facebook login, we began by asking people, what they wanted, right? So today, Facebook logging is used, people logging with Facebook over 10 billion times in the past year. And when we asked people what they wanted with a new Facebook logging, they basically gave us three things. First, people want more control over the information that is shared with apps. Second, people want more clarity. They want to understand when an app will post to Facebook. And finally, people feel that some apps, not all, but some apps, often ask for too many permissions. So, we showed this at F8, but I wanted to show you guys again the new Facebook login experience. So here's an app, RDO, which is a music app, and I clicked the login with Facebook button. This dialog could be very familiar to you guys, but there's a new control here that lets people edit the information that they provide. When you tap on this control, we show a second dialog. And this is really where the new Facebook login shines and why we encourage you guys to update the new experience. So here in the second dialog, people can actually deselect individual permissions. And so for example, if I want to deselect my email address and likes, I can go ahead and do that to not share those kind of information with the app. And giving people this kind of increased control and increased transparency, we believe will lead to an even greater increase in login conversion rates. So we showed a new, okay, so there's also one more change that we did with the new Facebook login. So suppose, Ilya, picture in the middle here, has two friends, Mark and Deb, right? Previously, Ilya can share not only his photos, but also Mark and Deb's photos when he logs in with Facebook to an app. So as you can imagine, this could be surprising for some people, especially for, Mark and Deb when they haven't even logged into the app. So with the new Facebook login, each person is responsible for what he or she shares with the app. Ilya can't share Mark or Deb's information without their permission. So we showed a new login dialog to people, and this is what they had to say. you know, here's Chris from RDO, who's VP of Product RDO, saying the new Facebook logging increases transparency and should lead to even higher conversion rates for us. We actually have a few apps already testing the new dialog, and you know, we don't have any specific stats to share right now, but the general trend is people are seeing higher conversion rates.
I like the fact that you can choose the info that you're going to provide. That's different. And I like that better because normally it's just, guess what, we're doing all these things because you are signing in through Facebook. Mm-hmm. And you're like, oh, Lord, okay, fine. So I do like that. That makes me feel more comfortable.
So those are just like two quick clips of all the user research that we did with the new logging. And I think the last bit, what this lady said, is key. You know, when people feel more comfortable, they are more likely to tap that blue button. They're more likely to share their Facebook information with your app. And they're more likely to sign into your app and engage with it. Right? So let's move on to the next need that people expressed, which is, you know, some people feel that apps often ask for too many permissions. So, oops. Kevin, can you open the slides again?
Yeah, one second.
Yeah, sorry about it.
Let's ignore that.
I think it's slide 18.
I'll find it.
Yeah.
Didn't like the video. Slide 18.
Slide 19.
There we go.
Cool. So kind of to address this last concern or last need that people had, we took a hard look at our login dialog. And, you know, I'm not sure, you know, how many of you have been unlucky enough to come across a dialog like this. But, you know, having worked on logging for over a year, I'm glad to say that I only see it in two different apps. But, you know, even two different apps asking for so many permissions, like negatively impacts the entire ecosystem, you know, including gray apps that only ask for permissions that they need, right? So to kind of address this issue, we decided to add a new logging review to our existing review processes for App Center and Open Graph. So here's a quick video of one of our reviewers explaining what logging review is.
I think you might need to go to the next one. Oh, there it goes.
We created a new login review process where the goal is to partner with you to create the best possible experiences for your app's audience. Our login review process is based on three main things, and it's actually really simple. First, permissions are all about enhancing people's experiences in your app. People shouldn't feel frustrated or worried. So during the review process, we'll make sure that your app's only requesting the permissions it really needs. Second, people want to know when the apps that they use are going to post back to their Facebook profile. During the login review process, we'll make sure that your app clearly asks for permission to do this. Third, we make sure to test your Facebook login flow on a variety of devices to make sure that there are no crashes or error warnings. This may all seem really obvious, but it's going to make a huge difference when building trust with your app's audience.
Great. So I think, you know, the key thing to remember about logging review is that it's a very simple and lightweight process. And even if you don't pass review, like, we're not going to shut down your app. You can keep on resubmitting for review until it goes through. So in fact, if you only ask for public profile, friend list, and email as your permissions, you don't have to go through a logging review at all. Only if you ask for, you know, more extended permissions, like, you know, likes or photos and so on, do you have to go through review. All existing apps on our platform have 1 year, so it started in April. So existing apps have until April 2015 to go through review, and new apps do require review before they can use Facebook logging and launch the app. Great. So to submit your app for review, all you have to do is go to our developers.facebook.com site and go to status and review in your app dashboard and click start a submission. So the new Facebook login is available now. And again, like login review, existing apps have until April 30th, 2015 to upgrade. And for new apps that are built on the Facebook platform, the new Facebook login is kind of the default experience. Great, so now that we kind of talked about a new Facebook login, I want to explain how you can all integrate this new login into your apps. So the first step is really to integrate our latest SDKs. You know, if you have the latest iOS, Android, or JavaScript SDK for the web, the Facebook login is kind of enabled by default. And we are, for games, we're also bringing the new Facebook login to the Unity SDK very soon. There isn't really any fundamental change to the programming model for logging with the new logging. You know, this is a pretty standard dialog in iOS. The only thing that you'll see here that we added is now you have a message here, you know, that returns all the permissions that the user has declined, because now people can actually decline permissions that you request. So, you know, what did exactly change? Well, for the very first time, we've introduced versioning into our APIs, and we have a 2-year stability window for version 2 of the API. So, you know, it's super easy, for example, in the Graph API Explorer. If you guys aren't familiar with this tool, it simply allows you to enter in API queries and see sample results back. But as you can see, it's super easy for you to select the version that you want to use. So you can either choose version 2.0, which launched with F8, or version 1, which was the older version of the API. You know, again, with versioning and with the new SDKs, you know, Facebook logging is built into the new iOS and Android SDKs. With JavaScript, you have to specify the version number that you want to use when you initiate the app. So that's versioning. Another important change that we made was we introduced app scoped user IDs. You know, today when someone logs into an app, the app sees that person's original Facebook user ID, and this doesn't change between apps. But with version 2.0 of the API, when someone logs into another app, they will see an app scoped user ID. So basically, if you are a company that owns, you know, 3 different apps, the user ID for those 3 apps will be different. And the reason we did this change is to kind of help protect people's information and stop apps from like kind of scraping user IDs and, you know, doing malicious things with their information. So, you know, this is a pretty fundamental change to our platform, but we want to make this transition as easy as possible for you guys. So, you know, again, you're fully in control of when you should transition from version 1 to version 2 of the API. For people who are already logged into your app before you transition to version 2, you still get their original user IDs. And we also have this new tool called Test Apps and the Business Mapping API to help you kind of map app scope user IDs between different apps. I know this is a lot to digest right now, but you can go to our documentation on developers.facebook.com to read more about app scope user IDs. So as I described before when I introduced the new login, there's some pretty fundamental changes to friend permissions with the new login. So the most fundamental change is that people can actually now deselect their friend list. Like, they don't have to share their friend list with apps if they don't want to. To help you kind of find some common use cases and get around when people deselect their friend list, we're introducing 2 new APIs. There's a taggable friends API that helps you tag people in posts from your app, and the Invitable Friends API that is currently limited to games, but is allows you to kind of invite, let people invite their full list of Facebook friends. And we're constantly working on kind of improving our friends APIs. So you'll hear more updates from us about this down the line. Cool. So once again, you know, there are some fundamental permission changes with the new Facebook login. There's some, you know, cosmetic things like basic info is now being replaced by public profile. And, you know, public profile does not include the friend list anymore, which is now optional. So you have to separate requests for user friends. And you have to account for declined permissions in your app. So, you know, on iOS and Android, you can send a message or a method to get a list of declined permissions. And you can do similar things using the Grab API endpoint, /permissions. So, you know, just because people have declined permissions when they log into your app, it doesn't mean that you can ask them again down the line. So if I decline friend list when I log into your app, and down the line I kind of realize why your app needs to have my friend list, you know, you can request to ask me for friend list again using the methods showing here. So again, if you want to kind of invite friends to your app, you can use our Invitable Friends API. And you can also try to use our new message dialog and just include a link to your app for people to download. Great. So, you know, many of you are probably thinking, you know, there are, these are some pretty fundamental changes, probably require a lot of additional work on your side to integrate a new Facebook login into your app. And so why don't I just wait until, like, you know, April 2015, right before our deadline, and do that, right? Well, the reason why is because, you know, as you know, it takes a while for people to upgrade to a new app, especially on iOS and Android. Like, on the web, it's pretty easy because you can just, like, you know, update your web website and everybody will see it instantly. But on Android, for example, you know, the upgrade cycle is very slow. So we recommend, you know, whether you're iOS, Android, or web, that you upgrade to the Facebook login, the new Facebook login, as soon as you can to avoid disrupting, you know, your user experience when the deadline comes. Okay. So here are some basic steps that you can follow to get started upgrading to new Facebook login. You can submit your app for login review today. You know, again, even if you do not pass review, there'll be no impact. We will not shut down your app. We'll just give you some advice on how you can, you know, pass review. So I'll give you plenty of time to pass review by the deadline. Next, you should upgrade to our new SDKs and make sure your app works with AppScope user IDs, handle declined permissions, and make any other necessary changes. So just to reiterate, you know, login review will not affect your app today. It's simply like a lightweight process for us to give you some advice on how you can improve your Facebook login experience. Okay, so that is basically how you can upgrade to the new Facebook login. Now I just want to use our remaining time to cover a few login best practices. So the first best practice, and this is more for mobile, is to use a login button from our SDKs. The login button from our SDKs includes, you know, callouts and controls. For example, when people see the new Facebook login for the first time, telling them that they can now, you know, deselect certain permissions and telling them about the other changes that we've made. The second best practice is you should include some education when displaying the login with Facebook button on why, you know, people should log in with Facebook and why you're going to ask for the permissions that you need. I think Wiata does a really great job at this. They are a local events app, and they say that logging with Facebook allows you to see tons of friends' recommendations and what they're interested in. And they reiterate that they will never post to Facebook without their permission. So just some basic language really increases your app's conversion rate and gets people to click that login with Facebook button more. you know, along the same lines, you should always ask for permissions in context. And I think one of the great examples from our own app is when, you know, a user is updating their status and they want to add their location. So the first thing they do is they tap on this location icon at the bottom right of the screen. Next, you know, the Facebook app actually shows our own dialogue telling people, you know, that turning on location services will give them more accurate results. When people tap on turn on location services, this doesn't actually turn on location services in iOS. Instead, this kind of filters out all the people that will not turn on location services. So the remaining people that see the actual iOS dialog are much more likely to click OK and actually turn on location services. So the takeaway here is, you know, make sure you ask for permissions in context. This is especially important when you're asking for permissions to publish back to Facebook. You know, people are very sensitive about apps auto-posting back to Facebook. So you should only ask for permissions to publish when people are ready to share. And the Foursquare app is a great example of this. You know, they make it crystal clear that, you know, when you're updating your status, you have the option of sharing back to Facebook. And the last best practice is, you know, you just simply test common use cases across many different device scenarios if you have a multi-platform app. Especially with the new logging, now that people can actually decline permissions, you want to make sure that your logging flow works across all these different use cases. So we provide a handy link here to help you find use cases to test. Great, so that's basically all I had today. Just a recap, we covered what the new Facebook login is. We covered how you can upgrade to the new Facebook login. And we also covered login best practices. Again, this is a lot of information to digest. So I encourage you all to visit developers.facebook.com, where you can read more about the login, the new Facebook login, you know, on your at your own pace. Marissa or Kevin, did you have anything to add?
We're going to open it up to questions now. So if you have questions, you can plug them into the GoToWebinar control panel. And Marissa, I don't know, do you have anything to add?
No, I'd love to hear the questions from the group. You know, certainly there are changes that we're making on the Gigya side to support you as you make this transition. So we can already support those V2 apps today. We'll be making additional updates to the permissions page within the Gigya admin console so that you can see very clearly what's accessible to you on V1 versus V2 and help to move you over to V2, obviously. There are a lot of considerations there, but the sooner the better. And Gigya is also your client services team is going to be your support there. So in terms of the app review process and incorporating extended permissions into your application and making sure you're only asking for what you need, we do expect you to work with us on that, and we're here to help you with that.
Yeah. So, yeah, we're getting a couple questions in here. So, Peter, this one's addressed at you. So the person's asking, what results or response from developers have you seen so far in terms of the new Facebook login performance or just general developer, developers adapting to it?
Yeah, I mean, I think developers generally understand. I mean, developers are people too, right? So the developers generally understand why we're making these changes. And from if they put their people hat on, you know, they totally buy into the fact that, you know, having optional permissions and introducing login review will improve the login ecosystem overall. You know, we have a few apps that have migrated over so far, both on mobile and web. And, you know, like I said during the webinar, early metrics are very positive. We're seeing higher conversion rates for apps that use the new Facebook login versus the current, the older version. As more and more apps adopt, I'm sure we can, you know, start publishing some of these stats. But, you know, I just want to reiterate the point that even though it might seem like a long time, you know, April 2015 might seem like a long time away. People upgrade their apps, you know, at their own pace. So we recommend that, you know, you try to upgrade to the new logging as soon as you can. And, you know, Facebook and Gigya are both here to help you guys do that. So.
Yeah, thanks. So I have a question here from Marissa, which is Gigya permissions are currently bundled. Will this be unbundled via Gigya, for example? only ask for relationship status versus also political views?
Yes. So we are breaking out all of the relevant permissions as they're available from Facebook to make that much easier for you. It is important to know that there is some bundling that does happen on the Facebook side. So, for example, religious views and political views are a single permission from Facebook, and so that will be no different within Gigya, but we'll certainly mirror exactly what's available through Facebook directly.
Great. So this person's asking, what do marketing agencies need to do in publishing apps if we're using a third-party development platform, something like ShortStack? I don't know if that makes sense to you guys. No.
I mean, like all kinds of third-party platforms will have to migrate, just like regular apps will have to migrate to the new login, you know, next year. So, you know, it just depends on when they put it into the development cycle.
Thanks, Peter. So another question from Marissa, which is, can Gigya help me with the app approval process or upgrading to the new SDKs, and how does that work?
Yep, absolutely. So again, your implementation manager will be your main point of contact on the review process. And so as you are upgrading to V2, or if you are a new customer who's creating their first app and it's going to be on V2 by default, please do consult with your implementation manager. So the process there is really figuring out what permissions you need and how you're going to integrate those into your application, such that we can help you to declare not only the permissions you need, but why you need the information that's relevant to those permissions, and help you to integrate it so that you can then show Facebook where in your app those permissions or the data from those permissions is being put to use.
Great. Okay, so we actually just have one last question. Which is, you know, if this person actually had their app declined, it looks like, and they it's because Facebook said the information is not good enough to provide the permission. So what can they do about, you know, readdressing the situation and coming back to Facebook after the app's been declined?
So if you get declined during login review, you can. I mean, depends on what notes the reviewer wrote while declining the app. But one way to kind of quickly get some feedback from the Facebook team is to join our Facebook developers group on Facebook. So if you search for Facebook developers, there should be a group. It's the group, not the page. And once you join a group, like the entire Eng team and the review team is on that group. So if you make a post there, you know, you can probably get additional feedback through that channel. But, you know, I think that's the best way to get additional feedback.
Great, that's helpful. Okay, so that sums it up. If anyone has any further questions, please just feel free to email us at info@gigya.com, and we will forward those to the right people and get those questions answered for you. Thanks so much to Peter and Marissa for joining us. And with that, I'll end the webinar. Thanks, guys.